Hey there, welcome to How to BIM. If this is your first time stumbling across my channel, I create tutorial videos about building information modeling software such as Navisworks, Dynamo, Revit, and so on. So if you're interested in such content, you can watch the rest of my videos. Or if you came back for more Dynamo videos, you're gonna like this one. It's about creating a script that can automate the creation of full metallic structures in Revit. So let's get started. First, we launch Revit, go to Manage, then launch Dynamo, go to the Home menu and search for our package. We're going to be needing the structural design package for this script. So type structural design and scroll down to install it. Here's the structural design package. Press on the plus icon to install it, and now we'll go to the library, all the way down to add-ons, structural design, model, and then we'll go to frame. We have by width, heights, angle. We're going to choose the by width, heights, frame node. Now we're going to double click for a code block. Actually, I think it's better if we use number sliders, that would be much clearer. We're gonna need three number sliders. So select it and press on control. We're gonna link the first one with the width, the second one with the heights one, and the third one with the heights number two. I'm gonna change their names. So if I'm gonna need, for example, to share this script with someone else, they wouldn't need to figure out which number slider changes the value of which element exactly. So yes, the first one would be the frame width, the column heights for the second node, and the frame heights for the third one. Let's change the value so we can visualize our frame. Let's put it up to, let's say, 20 or 25. Yes, that's way better. Okay, for the frame heights, we can set certain limits. But for now, we'll just go to copy because we have created the first copy of our, the first frame. We need to create multiple copies of it. So we're gonna link the 2D frame output with the frame 2D geometry input in frame.copy. Code block, and then we're gonna create a new number slider for the number of frames. Number slider, and we will give it a name, number of frames, and I can show you how to set the limits in here. Okay, so for example, I need a maximum of 20 times. I'm going to write 20 in max, 2 in minimum, and I'm going to specify the step, which is going to be 0.5 meters. Let's set it to about 8 frames. In the code block, I'm going to introduce a new variable, which is number minus 1. Why number minus 1? Well, if you're a technician, engineer, or a modeler in the AEC industry, you probably know that. If you don't, you can ask me in the comments. I'd be happy to share. Okay, we'll link the output with the number of times of the copies. We'll go back to the library and choose a frame.purlins. We will link the beams with the rafters in the input of frame.purlins, and we have created our purlins. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you're interested in automating your modeling in Revit using Dynamo, whether it's a metallic structure or a concrete structure. I'm going to create more tutorials about this topic, so wait for them. Now we're going to get back to our script and create yet another number slider for the number of purlins. And we will link its output. Well, first we could change the number to, let's say, 5. And then we will link the output with the number in frame purlin. Now we have DP1 and DP2, so we're going to create two number sliders, or one, and then we can copy it. Again, select it and press Control and slide it down. We will link the first one with DP1, the second one with DP2. So the DP input simply specifies the distance or the offset of the purlin from the edges of the frame. So let me just name these and then I'm going to show you how it works. So let's say, for example, DP1 is 0.5 meters. As you can see, it has created an offset of 0.5 from the edges below. And DP2 can be 0.4. So yeah, you can change that based on your preference in your structure. Now we're going to go to the side rails of our frame. Let's just set our node and then link it with columns because that's where our side rails are going to be. Create a code block and let's, for example, divide the height. Let's say, for example, 3. And then link it with heights. We're going to go to the h variable and link it with the column heights. And now we have created our side rails. I think divided by 2 would be better. Yes, this is way better. Next, I'm going to show you how to create the V and X bracings. We'll start with the frame V bracing. You're going to need a code block. We'll write 1, comma, spaces, or space, minus 1. The space will be linked all the way to the code block with the number minus 1 variable we created, and the space minus 1, and the output will be linked with the zones in the frame V bracing. I'm just gonna need to move this to the back so we can view it properly. And link the side rails beam output with the points input and frame V bracing. We have created our V bracing in specific rails. This is just an example, so you can specify where exactly you need your V bracing, because usually we don't create them in between every two columns in the structure. You cannot use this code block if you don't want to personalize this step. I'm just trying to show you all the possible options, so I help you as much as possible. Now we will go to the X bracings. And we will link the zones with the code block above. And then go and find list.drop every nth item and link the list output with the frame X bracing input points. Next, we'll create a code block and, for example, write 2, link it with N. And now we will be creating our X bracings, specifically in the purlins in the roof of our metallic structure. So we'll go to frame purlins and then select the output points and link it with the input in list drop every nth item. Make sure that you use the levels. Now we can go and view our model in Revit. So we can see the result. As we can see, here's our model in Revit, but it's still only an analytical model. We need to create the 3D geometry. So we will go to bicurve, beam bicurve node. So we're gonna link the curve with either the 2D frames or the beams output. We can also link it with the purlins output. We can link it with the rails output. We're gonna be using this node in the creation of multiple 3D geometry. We're gonna be copying it later, so yeah. Next, we need to fill in the level. So we're gonna choose the level. And then the type of the structural framing. You're gonna need the code of structural framing types. choose the type you're going to use, and then link it with the input and structure of framing beam by curve. And as we can see, we have created our beams, the 3D geometry of our beams. For example, we need to create the columns, so we're going to go to columns by curve, go to the curve input, and we can link it with the 2D frames. And as usual, add the levels and the structural column type. If you have watched my recent videos or the whole Dynamo playlist, you probably know this whole process by heart, because we've been using this node for the creation of 3D geometry of columns and framings, whether it's metallic or concrete or wooden. So yes, as you can see, we can simply copy these nodes and link the curve with the V bracings or the X bracings . When we go check it in Revit, we can see that we have created the 3D geometry. And yes, you can save this Dynamo script. You can change your dimensions for whichever project you're working on and save a lot of time, save a lot of effort, because modeling metallic structures specifically can be a very time-consuming task. I personally consider it a time-consuming task, so this can save you hell a lot of time. And if you want to learn more about Dynamo, or if you're interested, for example, in managing your projects with Navisworks, you can watch my other videos or other playlists that I have provided in this channel. And as usual, if you like my content, like and subscribe, and obviously thank you for watching.